getting kind of familiar with fans waiting outside or behind bathroom doors, or from what I hear, and being a huge global superstar. Please don't go,
girl. Oh. Look at how cute that little Joey was.
We were so cold. We were so cold doing that video. The note stopped, but my mouth couldn't close.
Really? Where did you do this?
That was in Boston. That was the cheap version of that song. And then we finally, it became a hit record, and we did a fancier video after that for Please Don't Go
Girl. Were you 12 there?
I looked 12. Yeah, I was 15 there, actually. When I was 15, I looked 8. But,
you still look young. Yeah, Joey McIntyre, one of the heartthrobs from the group New Kids on the Block, is here in New York City now.
You know, I like carrots. That's a cute name for fans. We affectionately call our fans blockheads, which is kind of cute.
That's
but,
endearing.
Carrots is cute, too.
But you've been on the road. I mean, obviously, lots of people came out to support you guys.
And they still do, thank God. Yeah, we're still got us playing in arenas and having a blast. So there's life after being 17 and,
you know. Took a break.
Yeah.
And
we took a break,
thing,
yeah.
Came back.
Yeah, I mean, I guess we couldn't have planned it any better. Just take a 15-year break and then come back and have all kinds of fun again. So
right now, I know you're taking a little bit of break because you are doing Shakespeare.
Shakespeare, yeah.
And Joey, I'm sorry if I'm like,
I appreciate
it. I'm having a hard time getting my head around it. Now, I know you've been on Broadway. You were a waitress.
Yeah.
But Shakespeare is a different animal.
And absolutely is. I mean, I grew up in the theater, so I have a huge affinity for theater. But to do Shakespeare was sort of like a bucket list thing for me, and then it happens, and here I am my first time. But I feel like I'm getting a master class from our director, Sarah Holdren, is
which
just
play
fantastic.
Is it?
It's Twelfth Night,
okay.
And I play Orsino, which is a duke, and he's madly in love with Olivia, who's played by Kathleen Littlefield. And the person who's going to get me to Olivia is Cesario, but Cesario is actually a woman, Viola, played by Hannah Rose Caton. And so it's you know, it's a double, you know, everybody's in disguise, and it's about love and thinking you're going to get one thing and you end up with another, and it's Shakespeare. So this is one of his comedies, and a lot of, you know, Shakespeare can be heavy. But everyone, when I say Twelfth Night, they go, oh, good.
So did you memorize your lines yet?
I did, for the most part.
Give us a little something, a favorite line that maybe you have
so,
in the show.
So in the first scene, that you know, I hear that Olivia doesn't want to see anybody. Not only does she not want to see me, but she doesn't want to see, because her brother just died. So for 7 years, she's going to wear a veil, and she's going to be done. And my reaction is, oh, she that hath the heart of that fine frame to pay this debt of love, but to a brother? How will she love when the rich golden shaft hath killed the flock of all affections else that live in her? When liver, brain, and heart, these sovereign thrones are all supplied and filled with one self-king. There you go.
That's beautiful. Do you go around the house
to be or not to be? That is the question.
That is the question. Well, I will be at Two River Theater during Shakespeare, whether, you know, I'm going to show up. And it's a great cast, great company, and beautiful theater in Red Bank.
So it's in Red Bank.
Yes.
When does it actually
premiere? January 11th is our first preview, but there's going to be an audience. And then we close February 2nd. So it's a small window, but we're going to be doing our thing.
So there. Will your family go and see this?
Yeah, I mean, I'm close. I live in Manhattan, so it's sort of, it's about an hour and 20 minutes. So I'm staying over there because the commute is kind of, but I'm all about the New Jersey Transit now. So anything
really?
You need to know, yeah.
What do you like about it? Or
I love it.
Like?
And during the holidays, it was very festive at Penn Station, and you know, it's never a dull moment there, you know. But I'm zipping back and forth.
They were coming up to you while you were
here and there, but it's nice. I mean, in New York, there's, you know, so much going on, you know. This.
So let me ask you, you lived in, what, you're originally from Boston.
Yep.
Boston. And then you moved to L.A.
L.A., yeah.
15 years.
Yep.
And now you're in New York.
Yeah, back in New York. I mean, I had a place here in my 20s, but you know, in L.A., I'm like, I was starving for the romance of New York, and then, you know,
really?
All the things you miss. And then
like what? What did you miss?
Well, just the the energy and the grit. But, you know, a year and a half, the romance is worn off. I am officially
You're
in the
over
grind.
It now?
Yeah, it's cold as hell. It's dark in February. It's like,
do
January.
You go back to L.A.?
Not really, no. Because I came here really career-wise to do more theater, and that has happened big time. So the power of intention is a powerful thing.
So we want to know how much of a New Yorker you've become.
Oh, yeah.
Are you riding the city bikes?
Oh, hell yeah. Oh, city bikes?
Yeah.
Yeah, city bikes. I never thought I'd be riding bikes the way I do.
Have you had any close calls?
Here and there. Those city bikes are like tanks.
Yeah,
but
they
are. I wear my helmet. There's bike paths everywhere. I mean, walking across the street is dangerous in New York. So,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's all relative. But, yeah, I'm a subway freak, and, you know, it's exciting, but, you know, a trip to Florida here and there is important.
We so were just there.
Fit in.
It
yeah.
is important.
Yeah, you got to fit those in.
Right, exactly. Aren't you doing something else in Jersey with the Playhouse?
Yes, I'm doing
right?
a show in May at Paper Mill. It's
Paper
called
Mill,
The Wanderer.
Right.
So that's another
What's
new
that about?
Show. That's about Dion DiMucci, who's from Dion and the Belmonts. He's from the
oh,
Bronx. And so
right.
I'm the Wanderer.
Yeah.
So it's his life story and how he got through that whole pop stardom as a young, you know, guy and learned to find what was important in his life. And so
do you have those lyrics and those lines in your head while you're doing Twelfth Night?
Well, we got some time to, I'm sure the, you know, there's going to be some changes there. So I'm not going to worry about those lines
exactly.
yet. But I'm excited to be doing what I love. Like I said, I grew up in theater, so.
So what about New Kids on the Block? Where is that? Are you guys going back on tour?
I mean, we just had one of our, maybe our biggest tour yet last summer. And then we have our cruise, which we do about every other year now. So we have our cruise in 4-day madness, crazy.
When is that?
In April. And that's 3,000 of our, you know, closest fans.
Right.
And
you were with Debbie Gibson there, right?
Debbie Gibson was last summer, yeah. Debbie
right.
Gibson, Tiffany.
I saw on your Instagram or your Twitter.
Peppa, yeah.
Assault
yeah. Yeah, it was a fantastic tour. Fantastic. And then, so this is sort of like a chill year for us, but I'm sure we'll be planning more stuff soon enough.
Beautiful. Well, you're busy in Shakespeare.
Yeah,
so.
Yes. Mm.
But
excited
we,
for you.
We do like a very like hard-hitting part of our interview right
yes,
now.
Serious
it's
stuff.
Five questions with Laurie and Rowe.
Okay.
And if you need some extra time, take it.
Okay, good.
Okay.
If you need
All
a
right.
lifeline, call someone.
Yeah, I got my cell phone.
Okay, good. Because who was the last person you texted?
My wife.
Oh, what'd you say?
It's a long story. It is a long story.
Did you say I'm sorry?
My last text was that emoji was like, with the eyes and sort of like that thing. It was a story because I was trying to cheer her up, but she wasn't in the mood.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Next question. Who are you listening to now, music-wise?
Oh my gosh, I'm listening to The Lobbyists, which is the band and the music who are doing the music in Twelfth Night. And they're amazing musicians. And lots of times people will incorporate music into Shakespeare, certainly this show. So The Lobbyists.
The Lobbyists, nice. We'll look them up.
All right, what is your favorite Shakespearean play?
Twelfth Night.
Good answer.
I'm just learning.
What would be second?
I'm a rookie, so. It's, yeah, I'm gonna go with 12th Night.
I have to say, I like 12th okay. Night, but yeah. I'm a Macbeth person.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't know, I just liked it. We did it in grammar school.
Yeah.
And it was just one of those things I, you know,
nice.
Just stuck with me.
Sure.
All
okay.
right. Who is your celebrity crush?
Oh, man. There's a lot of them, I guess. Oh, geez. I'm trying to think of my hall pass thing or whatever you say. You know what I mean?
Hall pass. Be careful.
Oh, man, I don't know. It's funny, what I find is I don't say it like, you know, I'm a little bit older. I never want to say anybody
yes.
too young because
yeah.
then it's weird.
Oh,
you know, I'm like,
okay.
wait a minute, how old is she?
But
you
it
know.
Works for Leo DiCaprio.
Yeah, exactly.
Betty White, you're safe with that.
You know, Blake Lively is easy on the eyes. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Okay.
I'll say that much.
Okay.
All right,
yeah.
the last hard-hitting question.
Yeah, yeah.
Boston, L.A., or New York?
That is a tough one because they've all been good to me. But Beantown is, you know, they've been very, very good to the New Kids on the Block and myself. So I'm going with Boston. Sorry, okay. New York.
All right, we understand.
I'm here, though. I'm here.
All right.
That's I'm with you.
You're
spreading the love.
Yes.
It's all good.
I'm
all right.
Grinding away with you guys.
All right. Go see Joey McIntyre in 12th Night at Two Rivers Theater. Which is in Red Bank, New
Jersey. In Red Bank. It's a cool little town,
by the
way. It is.
It's
a great little town.
Yeah, I'll see you on the train.
Is the boss going to show up, you think?
The boss? Oh, maybe.
Bruce,
yeah.
Bruce,
I got to go to Asbury and pick him up, and then I'll drive him back.
He does some stuff at Red Bank, too.
Yeah.
So you never know.
Yeah.
It's a very cool
great
area.
Great restaurants.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Joey, thank you.
I'll name drop. I saw Amy Schumer at the Riverside Park, and she said, I'm going to go. So, Amy, you're on. So apparently Amy Schumer's going to drop by.
Okay, there we go.
I like it. Yeah.
Thank you, Joey.